His favorite cave. Sitting on favorite rock and talking to my flip cam, which is one of my favorite things to do. So there's a little something on that flip cam. You mind if I wipe off? Is that okay? There you go. You look great. A risk worth taking to Laura Layla. Hi, Lala. What is a risk worth taking? And there's tons of different risks that I take in life. Cost to risk benefit, like my tiny house. I live illegally on the street. And any of my neighbors might complain and I might have to move. So I know I'm taking a risk and I behave accordingly. I'm really, really nice to my neighbors. One of my neighbors got drunk one night and backed his truck into my house so hard he broke a lot of it. And the next day I just went about fixing my house. Because I knew I was taking a risk living on the street. And I know that sometimes holding people accountable to their actions isn't worth it. Especially since I could fix it. It's not like something that was irreplaceable or irreparable. So I just sucked it up and took care of business. Because I guess that's part of the cost of doing business when you live on the street. I moved to a no-risk job, if there is such a thing, because for so long I'd been taking risks with my jobs based on what I wanted to enjoy or what I wanted to experience. I started thinking like, well, I want to work somewhere, but maybe I should work someplace that will also give me something else. I had noticed, fluctuation after fluctuation. Finally, I'm like, I'm going to go work for the biggest corporation I could find in a back cupboard somewhere. And I'm going to do a good job in that back cupboard so no one ever knows I'm back there. No one ever needs to talk to me. I'll just cash my check. Where I often take risks, and big ones, is out here. Not necessarily right here, but in the woods. I often get to places where there's a fallen tree across a stream, and I'll cross it, or I'll get to a place where there's what appears to be a stable rock slide, and I'll negotiate that rock slide, and I'll leave the trail, and I'll hunt a peak, or follow a ridge line, or follow a valley. And these things have risks. Every time I cross a stream on a tree, that tree might roll, twist, break. I might just slip off. I might hit my head on the way down and then land in water and then drown. The rock slide I think is stable might be active and tumbling rocks might be coming down. Following a ridge line might lead to another ridge line. It might be kind of confusing network. It might look different on the way back. And I might not be able to find my way back that day. Might be stuck overnight. Some people are stuck for weeks. Some people are stuck until they die out in the woods sometimes. So if you're thinking, if I do this, I might die, then what's the benefit? Sometimes the benefit is just an afternoon of solitude. I mean, can you imagine? It's so important to spend the afternoon in a place where a vast majority of humanity would be afraid to go. Like, not only are you deep in the woods, which once you go past 4 miles, I rarely see any kind of trash after I go past 4 miles. That's almost kind of like the high water mark of people. Then you go 8 miles in, and you're only going to see a very special kind of person. Someone that's really determined to get way back in there. And then you get way back in there and you cross a rock slide or a natural bridge of fallen trees. Most people won't do that. So I do it so I can be positive. I'm going to be by myself. And I could just sit there in the quiet, and enjoy the quiet. Like, for the risk, you'd almost think that, oh, well, you could enjoy quiet anywhere. It's rare to find quiet. It's rare to be alone. I kind of think that the risk is also important. Like, I might need to take some risks. And so I try to find something valuable. I'm sure that there's quiet places in the forest where I don't have to, you know, cross a rock slide or cross a bridge across a river. So there must be some sort of need in me. All right. Well, there you go. A risk worth taking to experience something that that you deeply cherish. Laura Leila, thanks for joining us on Favorite Rock, and I'll see you in the tubes.